You're tuned in on the Steve Paul Scene. Welcome to a musical happening with the Blues Project, the Staple Singers, Moby Grape, and Aretha Franklin. We're going to talk about and listen to old blues, new blues, rock and roll and gospel, and all the styles in between. We're going to see the latest in the works of the future, based on an idea by the torch parades and the stained glass windows of the past. Stay with us for some good music and a few more surprises. This is Steve Paul again. There has been a lot of talk about a generation gap between young and old. I think the gap is largely a myth. Too many adults are enjoying the youth scene, from miniskirts to hard rock, and too many youth songwriters are concerned about communication in their lyrics to be isolated from the world at large. Our purpose tonight is to show you that music is playing a strong role in the life of today's youth. The kids today are using music the way previous generations used written essays or picket signs or soapboxes. It's certainly not all protest music by any means, and it's certainly not all far out and freaky. Take, for instance, this poetic, introspective ballad by Steve Katz of the Blues Project. The poet-songwriters of Shakespeare's day might know what he is singing about, so why shouldn't we?
You can call me from a snow-white starlit stairway. I may hear and not be far away at all, but the sounds of our winter's love at nighttime, they have vanished, they have silenced into fall. You can crystallize through my mind's weary wandering. I may see your shadowed image on my wall, half staring, laughing, weave by your indifference. I would rather feel the pain than at all. If again I see your face before me, and we lie again together side by side, don't call me as I walk into the morning. Please just realize that the pure has often. From a snow-white starlit stairway, I may hear and not be far away at all, but the sounds of our winter's love at nighttime, they have vanished, they have silenced into fall.
Aretha Franklin has been an important force in bringing rhythm and blues to the forefront of the pop mainstream. Let's meet Aretha now as she sings to you of the respect which she has always earned and deserved.
Why don't you introduce us to the rest of the family?
Okay, Pops. Well, to my left, my oldest daughter, Cleotha.
Cleotha?
Cleotha sings tenor, yes.
Tenor?
And in the center is my son, Purvis. He sang baritone.
Baritone?
To the extreme left, the youngest of the group, that's Mavis.
Mavis.
She sang lead with a contralto voice.
Mm-hmm. Well, you've got a very nice family. I think, as nice as the music, and that's very nice, are the names. The names are beautiful.
Thank you.
And your people are beautiful.
Thank you.
Absolutely beautiful. And you've been singing for how long now as a family unit?
Since 51.
Where did you all start singing? I mean, when you first
got
the idea
myself, I'm a Mississippian. I started in Mississippi. But they were born in Chicago, and they've been singing in Chicago ever since they started singing, but I started down south.
And you started singing by yourself?
By myself.
And then you got the family together.
Yeah, I was singing solos until... I organized them as a group.
Right.
And we started singing together.
You have a sort of a background in gospel, don't you?
Right.
Quite a heavy background.
Right. We're mostly gospel and folk singers.
Gospel and folk
singers.
Let me ask you something. You've sung in gospel shows and I imagine in actual revival meetings, right?
Right.
And you've also sung at folk concerts and so on. Do you find the audience different? Do you feel that basically the way in which you reach them is the same, whether it be called gospel or folk, is just you giving out?
It's not much different. We reach them in, we've sung on gospel, folk, jazz, and blues shows, and all of them, everybody seem to enjoy the gospel singing.
Well, I see every reason why people would love you everywhere. Let me ask you this. Do you feel you're able to, like, through your own music, get out your feelings as many of the young people are doing? Because I think it's just another way of saying your thing.
Right. Yeah, lots of young people would like to stay for singers.
Yeah, I would imagine they would. Would you say that there's a religious connection, either directly or indirectly, since you have these gospel backgrounds, because you are performing to many young people, not necessarily in a religious place or circumstances, but there is a certain religious overtone. Do you feel you're able to communicate this to people?
Right. Anywhere.
Any
place,
What would you say you're trying to, you know, reach the young people with?
Well, to advise them mostly now to how to live here on earth, you know, and try to make this world better. That's the way we're trying to advise them now, you know.
The way in which they can sort of get along and
get along
live
and
out a nice life.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. That's very good. Do you find a lot of young people coming to see you?
More than ever now. Yeah. More and more, as time rolls on, we're gaining more and more young people.
Well, I would imagine you would. Because there's something very basic, I think, in what people are saying, whether it be gospel or blues. We've been trying to show that throughout this get-together, that everybody has their own musical style and their own way of expressing their feelings, but all it is expressing their feelings, whatever the style might be.
That's right. If your song carry a message, it will reach anybody. It will reach the young and the old, you know. So we try to sing songs that really carry a message.
Well, that's good. I think the message that you convey is not only a specific one, but one of a great love and affection for what you're doing and a tremendous feeling for the people that you're sharing it with.
One, two,
Didn't It Rain was an old Bible story set to the contemporary beat of today. A beautiful example of how religious music has always kept itself youthful by absorbing pop forms. Now, here's a new fusion of music that might be called country rock. Moby Gray from San Francisco is the group that mixes country and western flavor with a rockin' beat, bridging not only the generation gap, but the geography gap. matter how modern music gets, some subjects such as love and loneliness remain with us. Here's a song by Moby Grape for all ages and the ages.
I was sitting by the window, watching for the rain. The reflection of your picture against my window pane. But just the same, I'm playing my game, and I guess you're playing it too. Go ahead and play on. The times we had together, it was sunny every day. Now it's cloudy every morning, and it stays that way all day. But just the same, I'm playing my game, and I guess I'm playing it too. Go ahead and play it
Next two songs by the Staples, Ask a Question and Give an Answer. The question is sad, but the answer is sheer joy and hopefulness.
Why am I treated so bad? Why? Treated so bad, you know I'm a